started this trip the opposite of rurally, at Milan Central Station on a high-speed train to Ancona. After about 3 hours, we changed to a slower regional train and rode the final hour of our journey to the ancient mountain town of Fabriano. The owners of Base Camp 523, Marco and Silvia, met us at the train station. And after checking into our hotel, we met up with them and the rest of the group in an enoteca or wine shop inside a Renaissance building in central Fabriano. We had an aperitivo and sampled several of the local wines that are made in the towns we'd be visiting during the trip. Fabriano is a medieval town that's famous for its centuries-old paper-making traditions. So the next morning, we met with a local master artisan named Sandro, who taught us the history of paper in the region and helped us create our own paper out of recycled cotton. He makes lots of works of art, lampshades, and even purses out of his paper. Okay, moving on to the core of this trip, the biking. We headed to Base Camp 523 headquarters, where we had our final chance to choose between e-bikes and gravel bikes, and we all stuck with e-bikes. For the next 5 days, we'd be biking almost 95 miles across the Apennines from Fabriano to the Adriatic coast with an elevation change of about 4,000 meters. After we got set up on our bikes, Marco gave us our first daily briefing and we started pedaling. After a steady climb, we arrived at our first stop, which was an abandoned village called San Cristoforo. Seeing this place was a real reminder of why we do this kind of community-based travel. A lot of small towns in the interior of the Marche region are losing population, like many regions in rural Italy. So supporting all of these small local businesses, like the hotels, wineries, and restaurants that we're visiting, can really help people stay in these places and maintain their local traditions. We started our descent from the village on a steep road through a forest, which gave us a good chance to start practicing braking and controlling our bikes going downhill, with Marco giving us lots of tips. Then after leaving the trail, we biked for a few miles on a really low traffic road and arrived to a secret spot along the Sentito River. A few of us changed into our swimsuits behind a tree, and we took a very refreshing dip in the river before diving into our delicious homemade farro salads for lunch. After lunch, we had a nice little relaxing river time, and then we biked a couple more miles to reach our next excursion off the bikes.
You can see that we're not on bikes anymore. We're walking up a big hill to La Madonna dei Frassassi.
This site is a chapel and hermit sanctuary, part of which is more than 1,000 years old. It's near the entrance to the much more famous Frassassi caves, which are one of the largest cave systems in Europe and a big tourist attraction. And that's actually the reason why we didn't visit the caves, because Marco wanted us to focus on seeing things that most tourists in this area miss. After visiting the sanctuary, we hopped back on our bikes and rode the last couple of miles to our hotel for the night. We spent some time at the pool, had an Aperol spritz, and just relaxed for a while. At dinner time, we went to an agriturismo and had an amazing meal of locally grown food. There was verdicchio, a local white wine, local cheeses, both meat and vegetarian appetizers, two different pasta dishes, and a variety of grilled meats from the farm. We went to bed happy and exhausted.
Per quella ripartiamo, facciamo 10 km di asfalto, strada poco trafficata, molto tranquilla.
After breakfast, day two started with Marco talking us through the plan for the day ahead, which was going to be our longest day of riding. We covered 28 miles, or 45 kilometers, over some really gorgeous terrain through the mountains. So this was also the day when we really started to feel glad we'd chosen e-bikes. If you've never ridden an e-bike before, like we hadn't, you might not know that they still take work to ride. It's not like being on a motorcycle, but they just give your legs a bit of support so that the big hills aren't so intimidating, and so you can actually handle riding most of the day for 5 days straight. But we still trained before this trip, and we still had tired legs at the end of every single day. If you're thinking of doing a trip like this, and you're not already a frequent bike rider, I'd recommend preparing for it the same way that Marco recommended that we prepare. Start at least a couple of months in advance and ride a bike, any kind of bike, for at least 1 hour during the first week, 2 hours during the second week, and so on. And pack a pair of padded bike shorts. I have a whole packing list for this trip on my blog, which I'll link in the description below this video. By the time we got to lunch, we were so ready for it, and this was a great one. We ate literally at a farmhouse. It's not even a restaurant, but Marco had made a plan with the farmers, and they cooked us a 5-course meal that was just out of this world. After we finished our leisurely meal, we got all suited up for a bit of beekeeping. When we got back on our bikes, we rode just a few more easy miles that day, and it was one of my favorite rides of the entire trip as we crossed farm fields that were bathed in just absolutely gorgeous early evening light. And did you see that stylish Italian gentleman back there? He was pretty much the only other tourist we'd seen in 2 days. We were pretty tired and dirty by the time we rode into our farm stay that evening, so we were happy to see a pool to relax in before our dinner on the patio, which was another fantastic home-cooked meal.
Ripartiamo su queste bellissime strade bianche che vanno che attraversano i vigneti della Valle del Verdicchio.
Day 3 started with a homemade breakfast in the same beautiful spot where we ate dinner, followed by Marco's daily briefing. Marco promised this was going to be a nice, easy rest day for our legs. And it was true, we only rode 13 kilometers today, or 8 miles, through some more beautiful countryside. And it really felt like nothing after the long ride the day before. We spent the rest of the day learning about and tasting some of the Marche region's delicious products from local organic farms. First, we biked to Giorgio's olive farm, where he and his family make monocultivar olive oils. That means each oil is made from just one specific variety of olive, as opposed to the blended oils that we normally find in grocery stores. 3 of the varieties he grows can only be found in the Marche region, so we were really tasting something that you can only get here. After a tasting, his mother prepared us another fantastic homemade lunch, which was designed to bring out the flavor of the different oils. After lunch, it was just a couple of miles ride to our next hotel, which was also part of the biodynamic winery and vineyard that we were visiting. When we arrived, we had some time for a shower and then toured the vineyard and learned about how the owners produce natural wines, including some that are made using the ancient technique of an amphora buried underground. Then we had a tasting of several of their wines along with dinner, and it was really interesting to see how different they were from other wines produced in the region because of this unique process that they use. Day 4 was our reminder that we were actually on a bike trip, not just an oil and wine tasting trip. We covered a lot of ground today, 39 kilometers or 24 miles, with more beautiful views and one mechanical problem with my bike, which I was glad Marco was there to fix while I just watched. It was a nice, athletic, but relaxing day where we had time to really just take in the views and digest what we had been seeing and learning about across the region. We also rode through 2 medieval towns today, including our final destination for the night, the town of Ofania, which is built around a castle on a hilltop. We got there in time to see the sunset over the farm fields below the town, before sharing another perfect dinner at a local restaurant. Our final day on the bike started with a long, satisfying coast down the hill from Ofania. The whole idea of this trip is to see every part of the Marche region, from the mountains to the Adriatic Sea. And while Marco had been pointing out the sea in the distance from lots of viewpoints along the way the entire time, this morning was when it finally started to feel real, as we got our first clear glimpses of the water in the distance. We rode a total of 21 kilometers today, or 13 miles, and by lunchtime we were already at the coastal town of Sirolo. We spent the afternoon relaxing on the beach, eating gelato, and just taking it easy. In addition to gorgeous beaches and clear water, Sirolo is surrounded by Mount Conero Park, which would make it a great place to stay for a couple more days and go kayaking, swimming, hiking, or horseback riding in the mountains. Even though I actually spent 3 years living in Italy before this, by the end of this trip it felt like one of the most beautiful and authentically Italian experiences I've ever had. In just under a week, we made new friends, saw places we never would have found by ourselves, and gained a whole new perspective on this unique part of Italy. Plus, supporting so many small and sustainability-focused businesses along the way made it all the more meaningful. Those local businesses include Basecamp 523, Marco and Silvia's business, which I'd absolutely recommend to anyone, plus the numerous organic farms whose products we enjoyed. Hey, if you've made it this far, I also wanted to say that this YouTube channel is a project that I'm working on with my husband, Emanuele, behind the scenes as the video maker. But I also have a lot more content about sustainable travel and sustainable living on my website, tiltedmap.com. If you want to learn more, we'd both really appreciate if you subscribe here and share this video with your friends to help us keep the videos coming, and subscribe to my email list to keep in touch. There'll be a link below in the description.